What is up, everybody? I just want to cut this little video, and by the way, happy 4th of July, 5th of July, whatever it is that you have off. It's Monday. But I just want to cut this little video about the state of the drone business. I was chatting with a friend of mine the other day, and he made the comment when we were chatting that toy drones suck now. Okay, that was his comment. And he was right. Okay, he was right about that. But he was also wrong. Because they don't suck now. They've been sucking. Okay, this is a suck fest that's going on in the toy drone business. That's been going on for 2 years. The thing is, every once in a while, a product comes along that changes the world, okay? That's just a reality. I will show you one of those products right here. You remember this little gem? The iPhone 1? This changed the world. This changed the world. You remember Nokia? How about BlackBerry? You ever heard of them? Yeah, okay, long gone, gonzo. Well, another product came out a few years back that changed our world. Not the world, but I mean it changed the drone world. And that product was the Mavic Mini. For this entry point, no license required, no registration required. This changed everything. That everybody stumbled all over themselves to try to make toys about it and do this and do that. This destroyed the toy drone industry. Because once people figured out how reasonably priced this was and what this thing would do, they like, oh, who wants those junky ass toys? Okay, who wants them when you can have this? What won't this do? Okay, this thing will fly for miles. It'll fly for 25 minutes. It shoots 2.7K video. This thing, I literally beat the crap out of this. I flew this into that spillway, remember? With all that, the thing got soaking wet. Still flying like a champ. Even when I got done with the video, you can see the water dropping off of it. It was soaked. Camera module, everything. So, still flying. Didn't hurt a thing. I've flown 50 flights since then. That was last October or something like that. I've flown 50 flights since then, and it's still going strong. As a matter of fact, I bought another one just in case that one died out. After I did that, I said, man, I better buy another one just in case it rusts all up. But it never did. It's fine. But, you know, I don't make as many of those toy drone videos anymore because they're all garbage. I would rather, like, actually buy one of those little things, like, you know, like a flying egg or something like that. That, to me, is what the toy drone business is now, is those little flying eggs and stuff like that. As far as those things like the $200 F-11s and all this crap, I'm not buying any of that garbage. I'm not wasting my money on that crap. I don't even want nobody to send it to me for nothing, okay? Let alone waste my own money. I don't want them to waste their money. So, here's the problem, one of the problems I see with the toy drone industry, and I'll use the example, the F-11. Which everybody knows that watches my channel, I took it and stomped on it and broke the arms off. And I hear all kinds of comments about that thing. Here's the problem, okay? If you're going to make a batch of 5,000 drones, say for an example, that's what they did. They made a batch of 5,000 drones. 1,000 of them can't be no good. See, the whole problem with the toy drone business is the quality control is so terrible. So they'll make a run of 5,000 of these F-11s. I'm just using that for an example because that thing would not do nothing for me except for the first flight. So they make 5,000 of them, and 1,000 of them, you know, got to be returned, or that's not good enough, guys. It's not good enough. If you can't compete with this by putting out 20% of your product is faulty, I'm sorry, you just can't. That's just the way it goes. And then, you know, I still see a lot of people that I know out there making videos. And, you know, and this is nothing against them, okay? They make money. I make money doing YouTube. You know, I make a decent amount of money, actually, believe it or not. But I get a nice check every 3 months. But I'm not doing any more of those types of things, you know. I still fly the drones. I just don't post as many drone videos as I did because the market's down. People don't watch them as much. You know, I'm more like into the bikes now. I still shoot the video. I mean, I've shot a lot of drone videos last week. I'm not, I haven't posted any of them. Probably won't. I just do it for my own fun because nobody's going to watch them. I'm not going to sit there and post that stuff. What's the point of editing it and adding the music and doing all that mumbo jumbo? So there's no point in doing that. But I always take the drone with me when I go on the trails. You know, there's always a drone in one of my bags when I'm on the scooter or the bike, just in case something comes up, I can shoot a video. Yeah, so, you know, I still do that, and I still buy the little flying eggs and stuff like that. But as far as those other kind of drones, I'm not having anything to do with any of that kind of stuff. It's just not worth it. Because first of all, you're probably not even going to get a good one. You got a good chance of getting a third, okay? But like I was saying, I see the other people making the videos, and I know, okay, I know that these things are garbage. Okay, I mean, I know they're putting on the happy face and doing all that mumbo jumbo, but I know that these things are crap. But, you know, they're doing it for their marketing and for their sales and all that stuff, but I got better things to do with my time than make some video with some piece of crap. You know, people that don't do YouTube, they don't understand how much time and effort it is to make these videos. Okay, I mean, they just think, you know, you just go fly a drone and grab the video, throw it on the editor and, you know, post it on YouTube. Man, it's so far from that. It's unbelievable. You know, you take a guy like Marcus Crawford. I mean, he makes these hour-long videos. I can only imagine how much time he sits at that computer editing these videos. I can only imagine, because I know these bike videos and these trail videos I make now are all 30 minutes long, and it takes me hours to go through there and speed it up and slow it down and add the tunes where I want them. And, you know, that's a long process. You know, people think that this is some kind of 5-minute deal. They're nuts. I think Ron Brown's got the better plan. Make the 5-minute videos. He's good for the 5 to 8 minute videos. You know, these 30, 40 minute videos, man. Wow. That's a lot of work. A lot of work. A lot of people don't appreciate it, believe me. They just think that you do it for fun, but it's, you know, it's a lot different. All right, guys, I just wanted to talk to you guys about that. I'm still doing the drones. I'm still flying the drones, okay? I have, believe it or not, guys, I have enough videos that I already made sitting in my queue on YouTube that I could stop right now and not make another video for 3 years. I could just quit right now for 3 years and you'd never know. That's how many videos I have set to private that I recorded. I mean, last year I just blew out lots of videos. I was going up to Ohio, or not to Ohio, to Beaver, up to the river and all that. I made tons of videos up there that I never even posted. Tons of them. So, yeah, I'm still doing the drones. I'm just not buying any more of the $200 F11 type stuff, you know. I think the last drone I bought like that was that Exo drone. I think that was the last one of those types of drone. And actually, that thing flies pretty decently, you know. And then last year, I bought that Vivitar thing. But other than that, I haven't bought any of those types of quadcopters. I'd rather just buy the 1999 toy one to To me, those are better. That's the toy market now. You know, these other people trying to make pretend like they're DJI Junior. It's not happening, man. It's just not. All right, guys. Let me know what you think about that stuff in the comments below. Don't forget, like, subscribe. If you like the videos, come back. If you don't. I'll see you next time. Oh, I'm going to be on Ron and Marcus's show tonight because I'm going to post this video here in a couple minutes. But I'm going to be on Ron and Marcus's show tonight. So if you want to stop by and say hi, you're more than welcome. That is the Drone Nation show. It's at 9 o'clock on the Drone Nation YouTube channel. All right, guys. Thanks. I'll talk to you later.